It's Password. It's Super Password. Our special guest this week, from Give Me a Break, Lori Hendler, and from Love Boat, Fred Grandy, and the star of Super Password, Bert Bundy.
Hello, so good to see you. Hello. Hello there. Hello, everybody. Come sit. Join us. Off we go. Welcome, everybody. Thank you for the welcome to you, and welcome to you at home to Super Password. This is a great week. I'm really enjoying this, and I hope you are too, because we have, as I said before, two outstanding players, and I think you've seen that already. You guys are really good. No kidding.
You say that to all the players.
I don't say it to all the players.
You watch every week.
No, but the fact is, you know, this show really works the best when our celebrities are not only attractive and all of that stuff, but really can play this game. And so we really tend to have people on who play very, very well. And you are, as I said, right up there at the top, and I like that.
Oh, okay.
Thank you so much.
Just say thank you. That's
thank
all
you, Bert.
Okay, you're welcome.
Thank you, Bert.
Any business we have to get done here or anything that you'd like to talk about?
Well, last Saturday on our show that was just on, I made an announcement that I'm pregnant, and I would like to emphasize, for anybody who might have any questions, only Julie Koniski is pregnant. I'm not.
You personally are not pregnant.
I am not pregnant. This is not being done to hide something. I just wanted to make sure that everyone knows that.
Good idea, because you'll be getting letters.
Yes.
Is she really pregnant?
And some tabloid, to remain unnamed, will probably say that I am anyway, but
oh,
I'm not.
Oh,
they blew an article in People magazine.
That's right. They'll probably be calling me tomorrow. Give us the real story, Bert,
yeah.
You know? Absolutely. Fred, are you pregnant or anything like that? No.
No, I'm not even expecting.
Well, I'm sorry to hear that.
No.
Anything else you'd like to discuss with us, sir? Anything pertinent before we
Isn't
get on with
Isn't it enough
this?
That I'm just here to play the game?
It certainly
you
is.
You always have something to pitch here?
No, absolutely not. I just thought you might
not
have had
Wheel
something.
Not Wheel of Fortune, you know.
That's true, too. Here we go.
I'm a person. I have feelings. I just want to play.
Okay, here comes Rosemarie and Robert, then. Let's get on with it.
It's our test, guys. Don't
yes.
Hi.
How about this side?
Hi.
Nice to see you, Rosemarie. Thank you. Robert, nice to see you. And let's start with our challenger, Rosemarie, who just got here and
yes.
needs to talk about things and
yes,
win some
well,
money.
My name is Rosemarie Cheverini. I was born in the Bronx, New York.
Hey.
I've been here 16 years. I love tennis, classical music. And I just started a job with Los Angeles Philharmonic, so I'm quite thrilled.
Yes, that'll be very nice.
It's very exciting.
Yeah. Are you a musician as well?
No. I just listen with my ears.
Listen with your ears.
And I just love it.
Well, good thing to listen with, otherwise.
That's my instrument.
To listen with your eyes, it's not nearly as good. Thank you, Rosemarie. Robert is our current champion. He has $38,600. I may have asked you before, Robert, what are you going to buy? Tell me something you're going to buy. I always like to hear things that you're going to buy.
Well, over the weekend, I did decide that the first thing I'm going to do is go home and see my family.
Right.
Because I haven't seen them in 2 years. They live in Philadelphia. So that's number one. And then while I'm over that way, I think I might just hop over to London or something. You know?
Yeah.
That's another place I've always wanted to go.
And never have.
Never have.
Well, would that be nice?
Yeah.
You can go first class, too.
Mm. Well, I don't know. I might be a little frugal.
Yeah, okay. You know? Well, that's great. No matter what, I like to hear people say, I'm going to go to London. I'm going to buy a car. I think you said that.
Yeah, well, yes, I'm also going to do that.
Might buy a car.
Mm-hmm.
You got enough money to do both of those things.
I even got one picked out.
You do? Well, we can't talk about it here. You'll tell me later.
Maybe if we mention it real nicely, they'll send us
None.
One.
They don't do that anymore.
No,
the plug days are over in television, unfortunately. Okay, where are we? Where do we stand? You have just won the $200 puzzle.
Yes. Oh, that's right.
Robert is now leading $300 to zero for Rosemarie, and it's time for your first magic toaster attempt.
Yes.
There you are. Show the folks
toaster.
At home what the word is. The cash word is worth $1,000 today. You have three chances to convey this word to Robert. As you know, we're ready for clue number one, please, Lori.
Surrender.
Retreat.
Clue number two.
Game.
War.
All right, here we are. Third and final clue.
Surrender.
White flag, I don't know.
Oh, gosh. Any ideas?
Cancel.
Cancel. You said game, which was good.
Yeah, no Quint. Show was my thought. But that's
no
two
show,
words.
But it's that's the only thing I could think of. The word was forfeit.
But of course.
So in a game, if you don't show or have injury, what were you thinking? Did you have one?
No.
Nobody
five
did.
Five fit, four fit, no.
No, oh, please. That's the way I think. That's why I don't play this game. The $2,000 will be what the cash word is worth next time. And with our score, $300 for Robert and zero for Rosemarie. At this point, we will change partners and break away for a commercial. We'll come back and play some more. Hard word. Forfeit. In a game.
Buzzer honors our decorated vets as they battle on our Family Feud military specials. Buzzer's Veterans Sunday Salute, Sunday night starting at 8 on Buzzer. Brought to you by Balsam Hill. Beautifully realistic Christmas trees and decor.
Here we are back, and before we go any further, we would like to congratulate KBJR in Duluth, Minnesota on its 30th anniversary on NBC, which is very, very nice. Congratulations. 30 years on the network. Well, you've almost been on your network that long, haven't you?
Nine years.
9 years on Love Boat. That's really a long time. I'll take a couple, you know what I mean? It'd be very nice. $300 puzzle coming your way if you're ready to go. Laurie and Fred giving the clues, and let's get on with it. First word, please. Laurie.
Thin.
Slim.
Fred.
Lean.
Skinny.
Yes. I thought we were going to have a little trouble there for a minute. I don't know why. Skinny is the word. Robert, for the game, for you.
Is it Twiggy?
Is it Twiggy? Ooh, great
child
guess.
Of the 60s.
Yes, well, Twiggy's still doing great. Here we go. Next
and
word, please.
And she's put on weight.
And great. Gained a little weight. Gained a pound or two. Fred, please.
Bolshoi Ballet.
Yes, perfect play.
Very good.
Skinny ballet, sir.
Is it my guess?
No.
Robert? Well, don't look at me like that.
Why am I looking at you? For the game, Robert.
Is it a prima ballerina?
Is it a prima ballerina? Skinny ballet, eh? Next word, please.
Ballet.
I don't know what that means. It means... Aha, Fred.
Dussault.
Nancy.
Yes, oh, that's great, Fred. Nice going. Skinny, ballet, and Nancy for the game, Robert.
Is it Reagan?
Is it Reagan? Oh, I'm terribly sorry. Two people out there brokenhearted over that. Next word, please. All right, Fred.
Reagan. Ronald.
Laurie.
Office.
President.
Yes. Too bad. Okay. Skinny, ballet, Nancy, and president, and you need this one to stick around, Rosemarie.
Is it Ronald Reagan's son? I have no idea.
Is it Ronald Reagan's son? Yes, they're giving it to you. Ronald Reagan Jr. Oh, you didn't need kid. That's exactly correct. You're absolutely right. And now we have a tie game, and we'll come back and break that tie with the $400 puzzle right after this commercial. Don't go away. That's what it was. $200 for $300.
Jim and Joanne.
Here we go. We have a tie, $300 for Robert and Rosemarie. $400 puzzle. The winner plays $5,000. If you're ready to go, Rosemarie and Robert, you've got the little television set. Take a look at the word. We'll show the folks at home what that word is. And Robert, you'll start.
Threatening.
Okay, Rosemarie?
Hazardous.
Dangerous.
Oh, it's a perfect clue. Excellent clue.
Dangerous.
And every guess is for the game now.
Is it the Old West?
Is it the Old West?
No kidding.
No.
The Old Vic.
The Old West.
Yeah.
I sounded like Don Adams. Is it the Old West? Thank you very much. Next word, please. Rosemarie?
D'Artagnan.
Musketeer.
Yes. Another great clue.
Oh, we did.
Perfect.
Dangerous musketeer.
Dangerous musketeer. For the game.
Is it a sword?
Is it a sword? Oh! Didn't need sharp, didn't need flint, didn't need weapon. Unbelievable. What are you going to do about that? Whoa! Not bad, Handler. My goodness. Congratulations, Rosemarie.
Thank you.
Robert, we have to say goodbye to you, but it's as I always say, it's not with a heavy heart. You have amassed $38,600. Wow. Great, good luck to you.
Thanks.
Nice to see you.
Thank you, Fred.
Let's go.
Thank
come you, on, well, that was something, wasn't it?
Oh,
yeah. I'm not. For $1 million, well, maybe not for $1 million, for $5,000, it was worth the sword. Boy, that was great. You've never been here before, Rosemarie, but
no.
You know how we do it.
Yes,
I'm going to give you 10 words beginning with the letter L and continuing through the letter U. Okay? L through U. Everyone you get right, I'll give you $100. If you get them all, I will give you $5,000.
I'll take it.
Okay.
Thank you.
You know how it is right there? Of course you do. 60 seconds. Let's take a look at your first word, shall we? Here it comes on the board, and there it is. Got it? Ready? Okay. Good luck, Rosemarie.
Thank you.
Ready and go.
Sucker.
Lollipop.
M.
A wood.
Maple.
Dark.
Mahogany.
N.
Dream.
Nightmare.
O.
Round.
Oval.
P.
Buccaneer.
By pioneer. Pirate.
Yes.
Q.
Fight.
Quarrel.
R.
Grape.
Raisin.
S.
Spa.
Sauna.
T.
Binoculars.
Anything.
Stars.
Telescope.
Viewer. Yes.
You.
Cows.
Utter.
Yes. Wow. Boy, I tell you, you are so fast. Unbelievable. Nice going. Excellent. You're welcome. Isn't that fun? Yes! You did, huh?
Oh, yes.
Oh great!
Oh, yes.
Oh, great! Well, you had 19 seconds left. I'm telling you, it's so fast. Well, you only had to give two clues, I think, once or twice, maybe just that fast.
I couldn't get the
telescope, but you didn't. You had plenty of time. You could have said it 10 more times, as a matter of fact. You won $5,000. You now have $5,700. We'll break away. We'll come back in just a little with some more super powers for after this mercy.
Next on Tattletales, star couples battle in a tell-all game of secrets. Then it's no secret, Press Your Luck is battling the whammies. Stay tuned.
We are back. Well, we've had an exciting win, and it is exciting, Rosemarie.
I get
excited, too, and I don't get anything, but it's a lot of fun.
Oh, yes.
Here's a gentleman coming back that we've seen before. Come on in, Jerry, won't you? He's your challenger. Hi, Jerry. Nice to see you again. I should explain that Jerry was here with us once before, and we made a mistake. We never do that. It must be very rare, of course. But we did make an error, and in all fairness, we brought you back to give you another chance. And, of course, when he left here, he had $22,000, so Jerry's going to do fine. You get another shot, Jerry.
Thank you.
Tell us about yourself once again, please.
My name is Jerry Hoffman. I'm a law student, and I'm real happy to be back.
Yes, well, I can understand why. Okay, now, you've been over the end game three times, I believe, so you can still go just two more times. You can get over there, and then you're out of here, okay?
Okay.
Okay.
That's a deal.
Okay, if you're ready to go, we're ready to go. Here's a $100 puzzle, gang, and let's do it. Fred and Laurie give them the clues, and off we go. Fred, please.
Sacred.
Holy.
Yes. That's the way. Okay, Jerry, what could that be?
Communion?
Is it communion? Nope. Okay, here we go. Next word, please. And there it is, Fred.
Scriptures.
Bible.
Yes. Holy Bible. Jerry?
New Testament.
Is it the New Testament? No. Okay, next word, please. Fred?
Section.
Chapter.
All right, Laurie? He said section.
Section.
Verse?
No. Fred?
Piece.
Page?
All right, fourth and final clue.
Cart.
Book.
Oh, she was going for a rhyme on the last one. It was part.
Part.
The word was part. We'll put it on the board, nobody guesses.
They say only use rhymes in desperation.
Yes, well, you picked the right moment. Holy Bible and part, and off we go. Nobody guesses. Next word, please. All right, Fred, you're still up.
Ocean.
Sea.
Yes. Holy Bible, part C. Jerry?
Oh, yeah.
Here we go. Next word, please. Fred?
Individual.
Moses.
Laurie?
Human.
Person.
Yes. Okay. Holy Bible, part C, and person, Rosemarie.
Is it Moses?
Is it Moses? Yes. You jumped the gun. Okay. Moving our monitors out is what we're doing. This is the $200 puzzle. The cash word is worth $2,000. And Rosemarie and Jerry, you're giving the clues, so start us off, please. Here comes the first word. There it is, Jerry.
Peaceful.
Quiet.
All right. Rosemarie?
Hostile.
Warring.
All right. Jerry?
Angry.
Noisy.
Fourth and final. Rosemarie?
Dangerous.
Hostile. They said that,
no.
Didn't they?
No, the word was violent.
Ah,
okay.
Well,
put it on the board and nobody guesses on that one. All right. Next word, please. Show the folks at home what it is. And off we go. Jerry, please.
Manhattan.
New York.
Yes. Yeah. Violent New York. Fred?
Bernard Goetz.
Is it Bernard Goetz? Certainly qualifies there, as a matter of fact. Off we go. Next word, please. Jerry?
Whoa.
Okay, Rosemarie.
Lynch mob.
Ah, tried to sneak it in there, you little devil. All right, two words there. Doesn't qualify, Jerry.
Posse.
Crowd.
Okay, fourth and final.
Grassroots.
Vigilante.
Yes, we're looking up grassroots is what we're doing.
Oh, come on.
That's one word.
They're saying one, they're holding up one.
Vigilante.
Then it's good. On the board. Violent New York vigilante.
Is it the subways? It's still Bernard Goetz.
Is it subways? No.
Besides Bernard Goetz. Well, that's obviously the answer.
There's something else coming up here, maybe. Here we go. Next word, please. Rosemarie?
Charles
Siebert.
Okay, sorry.
Avenue.
Street.
Okay, Rosemarie.
Actor.
Madison.
Okay, Jerry.
Charles.
Okay, that was the fourth and final one. The answer is Bronson. Charles, that's what they were going for. So we have violent New York, vigilante, and Bronson, and nobody guesses. Here comes the last clue, the last word. And there it is, Rosemarie.
Movie.
Film.
Okay, Jerry.
Movie. Show.
Rosemarie.
Slang.
Flick.
Yes, that's the clue. Violent New York vigilante Bronson flick.
Is it Death Wish?
Is it Death Wish? Yes. I could not think of the title of that movie to save myself. Absolutely correct. Well, it took them all to get it. All right, Rosemarie, you are in the lead, $300 to zero at this point, and we're going to come back and play the cash word after this commercial message. Don't go away, please. That was a tough game.
Attention.
This is Gene Wood speaking for Super Password, a Mark Goodson television production.